The Broughton Partnership is three First Nations who have their traditional territories in the Broughton Archipelago, the province, as represented by four different ministries, Fisheries and Oceans Canada, plus two salmon farming companies. This government and the federal government have made huge commitments to advance reconciliation. And we have several First Nations in that region with long-standing opposition to the fact that salmon farms were allowed to operate in those territories. And there's a lot of public concerns around what these farms mean in terms of wild salmon health and other environmental issues.
The heart of the project was to safeguard wild salmon. There were a number of elements that were primary to the work. One, of course, is implementing the United Nations Declaration on Rights of Indigenous People. So we were able to set aside normal consultation and sit down across the table with government and design and implement a shared decision-making model.
The primary key issue that MOE had was securing the employment of our 600 employees. And so everyone in the room agreed that securing employment was one of the goals we would have for these recommendations.
Well, the first thing that really came to the surface was we learned very quickly that both the nations and the farmers both had wild salmon at the top of mind. And once we found that common ground and understood that we both cared deeply about the health and well-being of this iconic species, we set forward on a path to get the work done.
Well, this was a monumental outcome. We have a transition plan for a reasonable removal of farms. We have a salmon rehabilitation component, and we're going to have independent oversight and monitoring, which includes testing of salmon before they go in the fish farms, monitoring of bycatch, monitoring of sea lice. We as First Nations can have our own data, our own understanding of what's going on within the fish farms.
I think we all know that the best way to do business and to work in this province is through partnership and collaboration. And this recommendations that we were able to achieve and reach agreement on is an example of how industries and First Nations and governments can come together and reach an agreement.
Well, I think the nations came to the table with a broad respect about, you know, where we operate. We operate in small coastal communities, and we are really an opportunity for people in these communities to hold down a full-time professional career. I think that intent from the nations made it a lot easier for industry to find a solution that addressed their immediate concerns and to establish a framework for further dialogue to prevent the loss of employment.
I think what's exciting here is that despite the pressure to move quickly and to get a decision, there was the discipline of the province to actually take the time and to truly listen to all parties. And through that process, a relationship of trust developed.